Smokehouse Porter. I grew up in North Baton Rouge. My high is on that music, is in the music. Hence comes the name Smokehouse Porter. And then most people now don't even know my real name. I think I hadn't forgot my real name. The old Smokehouse got a sense of humor.
My name is Mamie Porter. I was born and raised in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. My husband, Smokehouse Porter, brought me into this blues world. We go all the way back to high school.
When I met Mamie, wow, she was looking good. So,
first thought, wow, you know, he played blues on that old blues style. You know, he was a blues man. You know, he was doing that real old country blues.
Mamie is kind of shy, but I knew that she could sing.
Well, when we're on stage together with my husband, it's just something about the connection. I just feel like I'm where I'm supposed to be, and that is making music with my husband.
A lot of times blues singers, they write about things that didn't happen to them. I wrote a song called Ants in My Pants, and that happened to me, you know. And when I got out that ant pile, you know, I was singing Ants in My Pants. Besides family, this is it. When I'm feeling low, I reach over and I grab old Smokey. It might be out of tune at times, but I love that guitar. The rain started like that Wednesday, and that Thursday, it was still raining. Didn't really give it that much thought then. And that Friday, it was raining. And then that Saturday, but man, we started watching that water. It never crossed my mind that the water would actually come in the house. They were talking about flash flooding, but that's nothing out of the ordinary here in Baton Rouge, flash flooding. But the water wasn't flowing. The water was steady rising. All the way down the line, we could hear boom, boom. And my neighbors say that those were transformers, electrical transformers that were blowing out. It looked like a lake. You couldn't even see no grass. It was like a lake. And Mamie said, we need to start stacking furniture.
If you were to come in here, this is, this was our kitchen and breakfast area. And now it's just a mess. It's just a real, real mess. A lot of times I'd sit here and practice my music. I'd have my guitar up, and me and Mamie would sit and she'd practice new songs. It's gone, the water. I think you might could see where the water level was here. But water just ruined all that. It just devastated us. We never flooded. But now, every time they got a little tropical depression, every time the weather man says that we're gonna have flash flood, that's gonna be on my mind. Is it gonna happen again? We had just bought this bed and the dresser, and we had some nightstands over there. All this stuff was brand new, but it's water damaged. So it's an uphill fight, but you know, we're gonna do what we gotta do. We survivors. We're in that survival mode right now. You got 8 foot of water in your house, ain't nothing for you to salvage. You know, it's just
it's nothing for you to salvage, you know. You just gotta thank God that you got out. There's a many days, you know, I just felt like I wanted to give up. And I still feel like this. I can't give up anyway because I got Mamie. You know, I'm not a quitter, man. But sometimes, you know, it crosses my mind, say, man, you know, it's just too much. You know, and just, it's just a situation that I never thought that Mamie and I would be in. But, you know, it happened.
This is our hotel room that we've been staying in now for probably, I'm gonna say at least 35 days, at least there. And when you walk into our home away from home, this is where Mamie does her famous cooking with the microwave. Mm-hmm. We got our little freezer here. We can't put a whole lot in it, but this is what we do. When the water started, one of the first things I grabbed was her and the guitar.
Give you a little bit of temporary sanity.
I'm gonna get my head back and get out with these down home blues.
That's just one single room. You know, we sitting there with nothing really to do. The only thing we can really think about is our home, you know. And I know you shouldn't put a lot of emphasis on material things, but this is our home, you know, and we want to be back in our home.
Smokehouse, about 100 pounds lighter back in the day there. I say those were my good looking days there. Whole bunch of pictures, and a lot of them was just destroyed. A lot of times, a lot of blues players actually live the blues. See, like this flood of 2016, Mamie started writing a song about it, because guess what? We lived it. Yeah, we loved it.
The blues is just a part of life, and that we can't change, because we all get the blues. We may not have walls, but you know, we're in our house.
It's been a long journey, but you know, when I hear the first nail being driven, you know, are we on the right road? So. Guys come in, putting sheetrock in, and we gonna change all the flooring, and hopefully the house will have a whole new look. Yeah. This is our little bedroom. Yep, this is it.
Where we rest our heads.
No television, no cable vision, none of that, but this is it. Welcome to the world of Smokehouse and Mamie. Yeah, we laughing about it now, but but it really ain't that funny. Yeah, this will be our first time really missing Thanksgiving, really missing Christmas. Tomorrow's like Thanksgiving Eve. So she would definitely be in the kitchen, you know, cooking and preparing. And a lot of times we had the grandkids over. And so we're gonna miss that this year. We're gonna really, really miss that. So we're gonna probably spend our Thanksgiving in our little bedroom there. It's gonna be a real different and a difficult Thanksgiving for us. Yeah,
well, so we're gonna make the best of it.
We're gonna make the best of it, yeah. That's a slow process, but we're getting that. At one time I couldn't see the light, but I kind of see the light now. Man, we used to have some of the best Christmas parties here. And the last person probably wouldn't leave till like 5 o'clock that next morning. We'd have a good old fashioned house party.
December 25th Christmas, but this is our Christmas, January 7th, 2017. So this is our Christmas for last year, and I'm just happy to see everybody out here. So the little Smokehouse gonna do this thing a little bit.
Community is just like any other community. You know, we are human beings, you know, we breathe, we hurt, we have feelings, and when a situation like this come up, you know, we are there for each other.
We are survivors of the flood of 2016. I mean, when it first occurred, I shed tears. You know, girl, you gotta get in a survival mode, you know, because life goes on. And that's what I did. And that's why we're having this party tonight, because life goes on.
That's great.
Yeah, so it's coming.
It's on, it's getting there.
Mm-hmm. So we were like the Flintstones, but we're kind of moving on up. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We are probably between 90 and 95% finished.
We got flooring in. We got walls. Even though we didn't have the walls, the paint, we made it home.
And it's not all about material things. You know, as long as you got one another and you're on the same accord and you're working together, I don't care what the situation is, you can make it better. Because everything else can be rebuilt or rebuilt. There is a silver line. Me and Mamie has always been close, but I think this whole situation actually brought us closer. Yeah, and I'm looking forward to rebuilding. You know, I think I got a little too old to move somewhere else. But, you know, our roots are right here in this house. And, you know, we're going to do whatever it takes to be in this house and to be in this house together.
I was minding my own business, doing my own thing. Standing by my window, looking out at the rain. Rain came down, water came up. I had to wade in the water to make struck the great flood. I couldn't believe what my eyes had seen, the great flood of 2016.